I am Tom Seyfried, professor of biology. We've provided new evidence based on lipids supporting the original cancer theory of Otto Warburg, one of 20th century's most prominent biochemists. He conducted a number of experiments on human and animal tumors to find that they had deficiencies in the ability to make energy from respiration or the utilization of oxygen. Basically, all normal cells use oxygen to make energy, and the tumor cells do not use oxygen. So they use large amounts of glucose, and their waste product is not CO2 so much as it is lactic acid. The production of lactic acid in the presence of oxygen has become known as the Warburg effect, and people now know this is one of the most consistent hallmarks of all tumors. The controversy in the field is what does this represent and how does it relate to the origin of cancer. We have about five graduate students, one research assistant professor, and probably about 10 or 12 undergraduates. It's an active group. We developed the critical animal models to test Warburg's theory. The biochemical component of the research was done at WashU, Washington University in St. Louis, Missouri, where they have electrospray ionization mass spectrometry. What we have here are the animal resources to do the kinds of experiments that are prohibitively expensive at WashU. So neither group could have done this without the other. Each organ is made up of cells, and each cell contains organelles inside the cell. And one of the organelles is the power plant that makes the energy for our body. That power plant is called a mitochondria. The mitochondria is what allows us to think, breathe, see. Everything that we do as an entity on the planet depends on the functionality of your mitochondria. You die because your mitochondria die. Cancer cells can seem to live without the mitochondria by transitioning to a primitive form of energy. As a result of that, they grow uncontrolled, and they no longer respond to the cues in the environment. Lipids are fats. This is the key lipid which determines energy production in our bodies. And what we're looking at is the molecular composition of that lipid. And these peaks are telling us that composition. So, In the Warburg cancer theory, these lipids are abnormal. And because they're abnormal, you can't make energy from that organelle. And consequently, you have to gravitate toward a primitive form of energy, which is fermentation. Knowledge is constantly changing. The reason why Warburg's theory and never went away is because the explanations for cancer today are deficient. There are the field is in stagnation, and the concepts have not advanced the field to any significant degree to include new therapies. So when one is left for many years wondering, you know, why is this disease here, and all of the current ideas are not working and are not effective, one has a tendency to look back and perhaps revisit some of the areas that may have been more fruitful. Warburg was one of those.